Hey guys, how you doing? Are you ready for a fight today? Are you guys ready for a fight today? Well, we got one for you here. We got in this corner Charlotte Katakuri, donut lover extraordinaire, going up against Don Quixote Doflamingo, the only man in the history of history that's able to make a water-dwelling bird aesthetic look threatening as all hell. Let's do this, yeah! We all know who I'm rooting for. I'm rooting for Katakuri 100%. I think he's got this locked down. I just think he has a lot more stuff in his toolbox, but Barry, man, Barry's a Doflamingo fan all the way. So place your bets. We're going to do this, all right? Yesterday, I did a live stream, and you know what? I get a lot of questions in live streams regarding, like, characters fighting against other characters. Sometimes they're characters in the story. Sometimes they're, like, crossover battles from other series. I get this really just innocent, just really short question from Vargas here that's just, Katakuri versus Dofi? Just, like, what's your opinion on that? And that was one of the things where I was, like, immediately I was just gonna say Dofi. You know, because Dofi's been kind of expanded upon more than Katakuri has. And we'll get into that. But as I stopped and started to think and the gears started turning in my head, I started to realize, holy crap, these two characters actually have a remarkable number of traits, you know, in common. Like, they're both in their 40s, they're both awakened paramecia users, they both have Conqueror's Haki, as well as Observation and Armament Haki. Luffy fought against both of them, Luffy defeated both of them, so it's like, there's a lot of stuff to go on here. So, yeah, let's do this. Let's say Katakuri goes up against Doflamingo. How is this going to go? Alright, so are all bets placed? Alright, let's get into this now. So, first off, a little bit of background. We already know about these characters, but I just wanted to bring up a few interesting things about this, just in terms of their place in the story, okay? So Doflamingo, there's no question that he's definitely been expanded upon, and we've learned more about his backstory and his history, because Doflamingo was introduced in chapter 233 of this story. That was way back at the end of Alabasta, kind of going into Jaya. It was more in Jaya. That was when Dofi first appeared at that meeting at Marijua, right? Shortly after that, right after Skypiea, we saw him in Mock Town kind of screwing with Bellamy and Sarkis. You know, he was doing his little string stuff, okay? So we see him periodically throughout the story, but it was years, like well over a decade before we finally got to see him at Dressrosa as the main villain of an entire arc, all right? But he has been set up for years, and the fandom, like, we knew he was there lurking in the shadows. Like, what is up with this flamingo guy? Everybody is apparently really scared of him. He's really strong. He's a member of the Warlords. He had a bounty of like 340 million before it was frozen. Keep in mind, back then when it was first introduced, I think that was the highest bounty in the series, period. It was a frozen, inactive bounty, but still ridiculously high. So yeah, we knew this guy was coming. We get to see him at Marineford. Just the entire time at Marineford, you know, people are dropping dead left and right. Whitebeard's having this end-all, be-all war with the Marines. A battle that could quite literally end the world. And Dofi the entire time is just like, oh, man, this is great. Shing, shing, shing. Controlling people, lopping off Orz's leg. He's just having a fun-ass time, right? So it's just like, what is with this dude, right? So we get a lot of build-up for Doflamingo, and then by the time we finally get to Dressrosa, we really delve into his backstory. Oda really gives us a lot of stuff in that regard with his family, his father, Homing, his brother, Roshinate, you know, how they left the Celestial Dragons, they left Marijua, and they had to be on the run for most of their life, and then eventually Dofi starts up his own crime family syndicate. A lot of stuff really expanded upon with Dofi. Katakuri, by contrast, was introduced at chapter 860. All right, that hasn't even been 100 chapters in the story. Oh, no, yeah, it has been. We're at 962. So just barely over 100 chapters ago, Katakuri was introduced in Totland, which at the very end of Totland, really, with Katakuri, I mean, he was mentioned beforehand periodically. Like, okay, there are the three sweet commanders. You know, you got Cracker, who was introduced early in the arc, and then we had Smoothie that was introduced halfway, and then Katakuri was mentioned as like, okay, he's the last sweet commander, and it was also hinted that he was the strongest, okay? But really, it did seem to a lot of people that it's like, holy crap, Katakuri's here, he can see the future, he controls Mochi, okay, Luffy, fight him, final battle, go. You know, it was really just thrown at us like that. Looking back at it now, I mean, there was a lot of stuff crammed in Totland. You know, it was a really stuffed pasta, so to speak, you know? You know, like, there was a lot of stuff Oda had to go on with, like, Big Mom's backstory. We had the stuff with Beige in there. We had the stuff with Sanji and Pudding in there. The Germa were included, which added a whole other aspect of this and Sanji's backstory. So, it would make sense why we didn't have a lot of time to focus on Katakuri. But even so, I would have really liked it maybe if Oda would have just talked about him a little more, you know, building him up a little bit more throughout the arc. Because aside from him being name-dropped a few times, we really didn't get that. You know what they actually could have done, and I was thinking about this, as the Straw Hats were sailing to Totland, they could have had Pedro, because Pedro's been there before, or actually, you know, Peckham's, because Peckham's was with them at that point, and Peckham's would have known a lot more about the Sweet Commanders. So yeah, have Peckham's do this thing where he's like, all right, guys, obviously, you know, we're going into Big Mom's territory, and she's terrifying in her own right, but you also have to be really cautious of the Sweet Commanders, and the Straw Hats would be like, who are the Sweet Commanders? It's like, okay, well, here's the deal. There used to be four of them, there's now only three, but still, you gotta watch out for Snack, who's the former commander, but he's still really strong. You gotta watch out for Smoothie, because she will suck you dry in like 2 seconds tops. You know, you gotta avoid her at all costs. Cracker is crazy. You know, he could do things with biscuits that you never were, they were more terrifying than your wildest nightmares. And then you got Katakuri. And Peckham's didn't need to go into too much detail about Katakuri, but they could have talked about how Katakuri is the strongest of all of Big Mom's children. You know, he could have talked about, like, oh, he went into an island and it just was covered in a sticky mess when he left. It's just like, he's the strongest. Rumor has it he can even see into the future. I don't even know what's that about, but, you know, just avoid him at all costs. Maybe some more stuff like that, because we did get stuff like that, but it was like really at his introduction. Like, Katakuri shows up at the tea party and Beiji's there and he's like, that's Katakuri. He could be problematic. He could see the future, I hear. And then, boom, he's basically fighting Luffy within like a dozen chapters and just getting into it. Something else also really important to talk about is their status as a villain or a bad guy, so to speak, okay? So with Doflamingo, that's not even debatable. I mean, Doflamingo is a pretty evil guy. I mean, granted, he's had a messed up, you know, childhood and everything, so you can kind of understand how he got to where he's at, but, you know, to be fair, even before his childhood was messed up, even before he was, like, you know, chased after and, you know, thrown up and almost burned alive, I mean, he was already kind of a messed up kid, you know. I think it's definitely something with Oda going with, like, the, you know, are you born into evil, or do you learn it, you know, nature versus nurture kind of thing, because Homing was definitely a very kind parent to Doffy, as was his mother. They weren't cruel to them in any way. Roshinate turned out great, but for whatever reason, Doffy, you know, he just immediately clicked to that celestial dragon kind of mentality, and he just stayed with it his whole life. But you can kind of understand where he got to where he was. But yeah, he was pretty evil. I mean, just the fact that he, you know, controlled Riku to make him attack his own subjects as he's, like, crying out, and then took over his entire country, and then turned the citizens of this country into toys, their family and their loved ones forgetting about them in the process, and then forcing them to work as slaves in his underground smile slash drug den, you know, like, day and night. That's pretty messed up, you know? Like, so yeah, pretty evil dude. Katakuri, by contrast, I mean, he's more of just, like, doing his job. I mean, he's a member of a Yonko fleet. He's an enemy to other pirates, like the Straw Hats, you know. But Katakuri, basically, when he was facing off against Luffy in the Mirror World, he was basically like, hey, listen, you know, I'm a son of a Yonko. I'm, like, Big Mom's, like, greatest warrior. This is our territory that you broke into, and you caused all this trouble, and you ruined the tea party, and you destroyed, you know, Mother Caramel's picture, and you did all this stuff. It's kind of my job to beat the shit out of you at this point, Luffy. So, you know, I'm a member of I'm a Yonko commander, so I gotta do this, right? But it wasn't like there's any animosity in the sense of, like, you know, like, Katakuri's like, you know, I really want to beat the crap out of you, Luffy. Just, I'm gonna get a sick jolly out of this. And he, like, he cocks Mogara. I'm gonna get a joy after beating the crap out of you, Luffy. You know, it's just, he treated it like his job. He's like, I'm gonna beat the crap out of Luffy, and then after that, over, I'm gonna have a nice little siesta, I'm gonna have a nice little nap, and then I'm gonna have a merienda, I'm gonna have my little donuts, and just, this is lovely, and just, that's what I do, I'm Katakuri, right? So, very important there just to look at your different aspects, because I feel like Doflamingo going into this fight with just, like, pretty much the evil pouring off of him, that would definitely, I think, give him advantage in some regards there, okay? So, let's talk about Devil Fruits. So, they both have Paramecia, Katakuri having a special Paramecia, which... Alright, listen... Every time I feel like I talk about Katakuri in a video, I did many videos on Katakuri throughout the years, I feel like I always have to tackle this Mochi Mochi special Paramecia shit in a different angle. It's like, you know, can he turn his entire body into Mochi like a Logia? Can he regrow limbs like a Logia? Or is it a thing where it's just like he can just reshape his body? Because we see scenes like this where he's very clearly regrowing an arm. So, you know what? Okay, how about this? How about this? This is another angle to take it. Like, the fifth different angle I've taken this fruit concept, this special Paramecia. Honestly, Oda, I think at this point, I would have just been happy if you would have made it a regular Logia. Alright, but this is my idea, alright? Maybe the reason it's considered a special Paramecia is because, yes, it does have all of the features of a Logia in the sense of, like, if Katakuri gets his arm blown off, he can just regrow another one, because we've kind of seen him do that, right? So, maybe, though, the reason it's considered a special Paramecia is because Logias have to be some kind of element that's in nature, like fire, mud, electricity, sand, snow, with Aokiji, it's cold, or ice, magma, light, darkness, those kind of things that naturally occur in nature. Maybe when Oda was coming up with Katakuri's fruit, he's like, well, yeah, it basically does have all the qualities of a Logia, but Mochi's not really a naturally occurring element that just, you just go and like, oh yeah, we're gonna go out in the woods and get some of that Mochi off that tree, you know, like, that doesn't make sense. Or it's raining Mochi all of a sudden, like, you know, it would rain water or hail or something, like, that. Maybe that's the reason Oda made it a special Paramecia, because it's not a naturally occurring element, it's something kind of man-made, but still, for all intents and purposes, it has the qualities of a Logia, from what we've seen how Katakuri can do this. He can bend his body in weird shapes, so if Luffy goes to punch him in the stomach, I mean, he has his observation hockey, which we'll get to that in a second, so he can see that attack coming, and he could just, like, mold his body, just, like, bloop, and then the fist just passes right through it. Or if he does get, like, his arm or leg blown off, he can just gurgle more Mochi out and just regrow it that way. But anyway, with the case with Doflamingo, it's less ambiguous. He is purely a Paramecia. He has the ability to control string. Alright, so, I'm gonna throw some questions out your way. Alright, if Doflamingo were to take out his string and use pentachromatic strings, which is like his basic attack, where he just creates strings on each one of his fingers and his thumb, and he just like, pentachromatic string, and then just like attacks you like that. What would happen if that hit Katakuri? We're not getting hockey involved yet, all right? We're not even getting Katakuri's future sight hockey involved yet. I'm just asking the question, what would happen if it's like Dofi's strings hit Katakuri? Would it either work like cheese wire? Like, if you've used cheese wire, it's a great sensation. You have a big block of cheese, and you take a wire, and you just slice it right through, and it goes straight even. Oh, it's such a great sensation to cut cheese that way. But would it work like that, where the mochi just gets sliced, and just Katakuri just gets sliced into five different sections because of the string? Or, other option, Katakuri's mochi, the strength of the mochi is not just the fact it's like a viscous, kind of semi-solid that he can kind of gurgle out and stuff, it's also extraordinarily sticky. That's another aspect of it that he takes advantage of, where he, like, kicks Luffy with his mochi, like, foot, but then Luffy doesn't just get bounced away. He gets stuck in the mochi, and Katakuri can then proceed to just, like, speed bag him, just, you know, because he's, like, stuck in the mochi, he can't move. So, would the string get stuck inside of Katakuri? Like, the string hits him and just kind of gets sucked in a little bit, but then gets stuck, and then Katakuri could just be like, grab the string and then just yank freaking Dofla, like, what the hell? And then BAM! Right in the face. The way that I'm looking at it here, just my opinion, I feel like Dofi's string is just default, it's sharp enough to slice right through it. So I'm going with the cheese wire idea. I'm going with the idea, like, yeah, maybe if he bundles his string up, because he does that too, he makes, like, you know, larger strings to kind of, like, impale his opponents. Maybe if he did something like that, where he took his string and bundled it up and, like, tried to pierce him, maybe then it would kind of get stuck in him. But if you're just taking, like, one piece of string, like, or you're doing, like, bullet thread or something like that, I think if he just swings that fast enough, I think it would just, like, slice right through Katakuri's body. It doesn't really matter, though, because, you know, he can just reform itself. So, honestly, the string could kind of do something like this, where the string could be coming at Katakuri, hit him, and start to go through him. But the mochi is, like, healing him as it goes. So, it's like the mochi, like, the string hits him and just slicing through the mochi, and it's just like, glub, 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 and then the string goes out the other way, and Katakuri is still standing there perfectly fine. You know, the string didn't get caught, but it also didn't slice him in half or anything like that. So, yeah. Now, this is also something that is comparable because they both have abilities with their devil fruits that allow them to summon heat. Like, Luffy has Red Hawk, you know, he goes, you know, gear second, uses Haki, and then, like, the friction just ignites it. Well, Doflamingo has an ability very similar to that called Overheat, which is an amazing name for an attack, by the way. Also, you know, Torkoal, eat your heart out, Dofi, Overheat, way cooler. So anyway, yeah, this is where Doflamingo creates a particularly large string. It's more like a cable that would, like, support, like, a bridge or something. Creates a super long cable out of his hand with string, and then kind of just whips that back and then just cracks that sucker at, like, bullet speed. Just, and then sends it right back, and then the kickback on that thing with so much friction heats up that cable, and then that does have the potential to just slice through entire buildings with the power of that freaking technique, Overheat. Meanwhile, you have Katakuri that has the power of Grilled Mochi, where kind of a similar concept with Red Hawk, and I'm pretty sure that's what Oda was going for, because the whole idea between Katakuri versus Luffy at the beginning of that fight anyway was, you know, anything you can stretch, I can stretch better, I can stretch anything better than you. You know, Katakuri can do all these abilities Luffy has. Luffy has Elephant Gun, Katakuri can kind of do Elephant Gun too. Luffy has Red Hawk, Katakuri can, you know, use Grilled Mochi, so he armament hockeys up his arm, and then he just once again does it really fast, and it can ignite, and then he uses the technique Grilled Mochi. Now, with the regard here, though, I will say this. When it comes to Doflamingo, he could probably make more than one Overheat whip at once, but we only really saw him use it, like, once. Like, he creates the one cable and uses the whip. With Katakuri, a great aspect of his fruit is the fact that he can make multiple hands. You know, he can make, like, a dozen hands all around him, all clad in armament hockey, all using Grilled Mochi at the same time. So, I feel like if Katakuri were to, you know, parry that Overheat ability, he can make a few fists to, like, you know, cancel out the attack, like, send three of his, like, Grilled Mochi times three, and then Overheat, and it hits it, might clash a little bit. Even if Overheat wins, Katakuri still has, like, 10 other fists that are also Grilled Mochi fists that are all slamming into him at the same time. Alright, so, yeah, now maybe Doflamingo can make multiple of those. Maybe he can make, like, out of each one of his fingers, he can make, like, a cable, like, with Overheat, and he can just, like, swoop, and then just fire them all off at once. We've just never seen him do something like that, but they both have fire-based abilities, which I thought was really interesting here. And keep in mind, both of these characters have had their Devil Fruits for a very long time. Doflamingo got his power of the Ito Ito no Mi when he was 10. He's 41 right now, so he's had it for 31 years. Katakuri is 48, which he doesn't look 48, right? He looks pretty good for his age. 48 years old. He had his Mochi Mochi fruit when he was 5. Okay, so that means he's had his fruit 43 years. That's 12 years more than Doflamingo has had, so he's had 12 more years to train with his ability, all right? So I have to say that's got to give you a little bit of an edge there. Now, I would say that Dofi, just because of his upbringing and the way he was treated growing up, he has a lot more rage and hatred boiling in him, so maybe he took his training and his devil fruit a lot more seriously. Katakuri did also have kind of a sad backstory where people would make fun of his mouth and everything, and they set him up as being, like, this, you know, great older brother, so he had a lot of stuff to live up to and a lot of, like, rumors. He had to, like, oh, okay, I never lay down. I'm always strong. I always win no matter matter what. I never sit down. You know, that kind of stuff he had to live up to. But it wasn't the same level that Dofie had to deal with. Dofie literally had to climb his way up from the trash heap in order to, you know, regain his power and become the master of this crime syndicate. So I can feel Dofie, at least in his younger years, in his teenage years, training with his string fruit, you know, maybe a little bit more than Katakuri did, you know, just because he had a lot more stuff driving him, I guess. Katakuri did too, but I think Doflamingo just edges him out on that one regard there. So, you know, just in that regard, though, let's talk about an awakening. Okay, so Katakuri can obviously transform the surrounding area into mochi, or mochi's paste to be more specific, like this viscous, like semi-solid, you know, very sticky, and he can make rivers of this stuff. He can turn the ground and the walls and the houses into it and everything. Meanwhile, you have Doflamingo that can transform the area into string. Here is a question that has never really come up in the One Piece world yet. I'm interested to hear your opinion on this. Let's say Katakuri turns the battleground into string. Could Katakuri then just turn around and change it into mochi? Like, I turn the battlefield into string. Well, I turn it into mochi. Well, I turn it back into string. Well, I turn it back into mochi. And it's just like back and forth, back and forth. How would that work? What would be the determining factor there on which one edges each other out? Like, is it like a first come, first serve kind of thing where Doflamingo's like, all right, I transform this house into string. It will forever be string. I was the Devil Fruit user that touched it first. So even though you are also an awakened Devil Fruit user, this house is off limits. Maybe it might be something like that. Maybe it might be something more with, like, because willpower in hockey is also something that's very integral in fights in One Piece. Not just, like, willpower with hockey, but just willpower in general. Maybe it might come down to the number of, you know, years you've been training with your fruit. Katakuri's had his longer. So maybe that, I don't know what that is. Or maybe it really could just be a battle of, you know, back and forth like that, where it's like string ground, mochi ground, string ground, mochi ground. You know, kind of like that fight in Bleach when Toshiro was going up against Haribel. Haribel can control water. Toshiro could, you know, freeze the water into ice, and then Haribel could just melt the ice back into water again, and it was like this back and forth, like yin-yang sort of deal. We haven't really seen a battle between two awakened Devil Fruit users, so, I mean, well, we saw the fight between Aokiji and Akainu. We didn't really get to see it, but we knew it happened, and we saw Punk Hazard perfectly, like, half of it ice, half of it magma, so maybe it is a regard of just like, all right, I have this domain under my control, you can't touch this, same thing with the opposite end. But then again, those were Alogia awakened, so they're a little different than, you know, the awakenings of Paramecia, so yeah, that's the only fight between awakens we've seen, and we haven't really even seen that in its full scope, right? So I do like to imagine that, though. I like to imagine that, you know, if Doflamingo does turn the land into string, and, you know, even if Katakuri doesn't turn it into mochi, he could just make a bunch of mochi to cover the string, and the string would get all bunched up, you know, like, in the ground. It would get all sticky and gooey. It's one thing when Doflamingo's, like, making a string to, like, shing, like, really fast, like, cut through Katakuri. It's another thing altogether to just, like, I have a house made of bundled up string. I have the ground turned into string. You know, Katakuri could just be like, all right, I'm gonna make a crap ton of mochi out of my own body and just cover it with, like a fire hose of mochi, just covering up the ground. I'm not even turning the ground into mochi, I'm just coating it with mochi. You know, your string's gonna be all bundled together there, you know, you're not gonna be able to use it as much. Like, you're gonna try to, like that off-white, or that flap thread that Doflamingo did. He turned the ground into string, and then he, like, made the string into, like, wings, and he, like, tried to enclose it on Luffy. If it's all covered and slathered and stuck together with mochi, I don't think he'd be able to use that technique to the same level of efficiency that he did against Luffy. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just saying, in that regard, like, yeah, under certain circumstances, the string manipulated by Doflamingo could cut right through Katakuri's mochi. But, you know, if it's just he's turning the ground into it and he's just making it all sticky, I don't, like, ah, man, I can't control it. It's too stuck together. It's like it's all gunked up. You know, I think that would definitely be the case there. So I think in terms of an awakening, I think Katakuri, I'm gonna have to give the edge to him on that regard, you know. Now, something else I wanted to bring up, Doflamingo can fly. Katakuri cannot. He might be able to fly. I mean, I guess Katakuri, can he just, like, shoot, like, a jet of mochi out of his feet and just, Katakuri man away! Mochi man away! and just, you know, like a jet propulsion, except it's mochi. I guess he could do that. So yeah, kind of like that, where maybe he could stretch his body like that, or he can extend his arm or something like that and reach out. Or it doesn't even have to be his own arm. Katakuri can make, like, another arm made of mochi that can also stretch out and grab things and pull it back to him. Yeah, Dofi can do that too with his string, but it's just, it's easier to articulate an attack with your own fists and your hands and stuff, and Katakuri can make a bunch of them, right? But yeah, Katakuri can't fly in the traditional sense. Dofi can, like, run strings through clouds, or if he's in a building, you know, surrounded by, like, city buildings or whatever, he can just, like, latch onto those, and he can basically just use his string to stay suspended in the air as long as he has something to latch onto, even if they're clouds. So, that really just comes down to where they're fighting. If they're fighting in an enclosed building or room, you know, like the mirror world or something, where, yeah, there's ceilings, but Katakuri could also be able to reach the ceilings. If they're fighting outside, where, you know, Doflamingo can just, like, latch onto a cloud and just, like, you know, grab that and just, like, hang out in the sky and just launch, like, overheats and strings and bullet threads from above, that's, you know, obviously more advantage there would be going to Dofi, because he can just, like, stay up there, maybe out of the range of Katakuri, so to speak, because he could be, like, literally hundreds and hundreds of feet in the air. Where, I mean, I'm thinking, you know, maybe Katakuri could stretch his body to get a little bit closer, but he can't really fly from what we've seen him do, you know? So let's get on to hockey now, and I don't think I have to really even bring up the observation difference. You know, obviously Katakuri has been training in observation for most of his life. That's probably honestly what he's focusing on mainly, and so he has the ability to see into the future. He has his future sight power. Even Luffy right now has a little bit of that. You know, he knows how it works, and he's understanding it, but he's not as perfect as Katakuri, because Katakuri had, like, years and decades to work on this, right? Luffy really just learned hockey 2 years ago. So Doflamingo doesn't have that. Doflamingo has really good observation, but it's not to the level of Katakuri, where he can see a little bit into the future, and that was not displayed at all during the battle between him and Luffy in the slightest. If that was the case, then I don't think Dofi would have tried to stress test that King Kong gun the way he did. Like, you know, 16 holy bullets, god thread, spider web. Like, if Dofi had the power to see into the future like Katakuri, he would have been like, alright, I've thrown up my spider web as a defense, and now my strongest attack, 16 holy bolts, future sight, ding! Oh crap, no! And just moves as the King Kong gun comes at him. So yeah, Dofi doesn't have that power. The edge in observation immediately goes to Katakuri. But as we've seen with the fight between Luffy and Katakuri, Katakuri just demolished Luffy in the early stages of that fight. And keep in mind, the fight between Luffy and Katakuri, we can't really use that as an absolute parallel between, like, that's how the fight between Dofi and Katakuri would go. For a few reasons. Number one, Luffy, more than anything, was trying to buy time. Okay, because he's like, okay, I have to keep this guy here while my crew gets away so that he doesn't deal with them. So I have to keep him in this mirror world fighting me as long as possible. And it was like something like 12 hours he was fighting Katakuri on and off, like with just hit and run strategies. Like, use gear 4, fight Katakuri, run away through the mirrors, 10 minutes later, get my hockey back, jump back through the mirror, keep on fighting him. Like, that's what Luffy was trying to do, all right? It wasn't like Luffy was trying to defeat... I mean, he was trying to defeat Katakuri as quickly as possible. But he realized pretty early on this wasn't going to be an easy fight. This wasn't going to be a quick fight. And more than anything, he had to make sure that he, you know, kept Katakuri busy while his crew was escaping. Okay? So it's like, all right, I need to finish this guy off, but I can't do that quickly. That's not going to happen. He's way too strong to finish him off in just one attack. So I'm just going to have to just keep, you know, fading in and out and keeping him busy as much as possible. I can't just leave. I have to keep him preoccupied. Okay. That would not be the scenario I'm picturing between Dofi and Katakuri. They would be more of a traditional fight where it's just like, hey, what are you looking at? He's just like, you have funny eyeglasses. Yeah, well, you got a funny mouth. Oh, you didn't just say that. You know, and they just start fighting and try to finish each other off as quickly as possible, okay? So you can't really use that as a parallel there. Like Dofi's not going to be like, all right, this guy's really strong. I'm going to run away and try to think of a plan. You know, that's not, I'm just going to just go at him full power and we'll see who wins, basically kind of deal right there, right? So yeah, in the earlier stages of that fight, though, what I was trying to get across here, the only reason that Luffy was kind of of able to get a grasp on the observation hockey that Katakuri had was because that fight stretched on as long as it did. Because the fight went on for hours and hours and hours and hours, Luffy was able to slowly kind of like, all right, I understand what he's doing now. He's using observation to see into the future, to see when my attacks are coming, and then he's bending his body in a way where my attacks are passing through him. So if I can figure out a way to kind of learn that observation myself on the fly and, you know, dodge his own attacks while damaging him, if I can break his concentration, that'll break his haki. Luffy had a lot more time to kind of think of a strategy here. Now, Doflamingo's a really smart cookie, so he might very likely be able to come up with that same conclusion that Luffy did. Luffy is not book smart, but when it comes to battles, he can come up with some pretty clever maneuvers, right? I'm just saying, though, in a straight-up battle between Katakuri and Doffy, it would last a little while. It wouldn't be over like that, but it would not last nearly as long as Luffy versus Katakuri did, like 12 hours. You know, it probably wouldn't even last longer than an hour. I mean, they would get into a pretty intense brawl, but I think that a winner would be decided in less than that. Okay, so, you know, maybe Doflamingo would know, like, what he's doing. He maybe figures out the trick and might be able to distract Katakuri to, like, screw up his future sight. But I don't think Doflamingo would be able to, like, figure out the haki to use it for himself that quickly. Maybe he would. Maybe I'm not giving Doflamingo enough credit here. But it's just, like, I'm just saying, Luffy had hours to kind of work with this. And, you know. And I also feel like Katakuri, like I said, he doesn't have an animosity, like a visceral hatred for Luffy. In fact, as the battle went on, they actually kind of began to understand each other a little more. And that's a big aspect of that you can't overlook. It's just like, there's been that discussion of like, did Katakuri let Luffy win? No. Katakuri did not let Luffy win, but they began to have a little bit of understanding with each other. It's sort of like a, all right, we have to fight. There has to be a winner. I can't let you leave. I can't let you go back and terrorize Totland, which is my home, and, you know, terrorize my mom, who is a Yonko. I'm gonna have to give it my all to beat you down here. But I kind of have a respect for you at the same time, you know, just like, man, I didn't think much of you at first, Luffy, but man, you kept standing back up and you kept fighting me and you started to figure out my haki and everything. You figured out my tricks. And then of course, when Flompei showed up and they both had that scene where it's like, man, Peanut Gallery's getting a little bit loud over there. Yeah, I agree. Conqueror's Burst! Boom! And then knocked out Flompei. That was kind of a moment where, that was a little bit of a bro moment between Katakuri and Luffy. You gotta admit that. It's just like, alright, that was pretty cool. Alright. Katakuri versus Luffy was more of like a professional fight. It was more of like a boxing match or like an MMA match or something. Your opponent in a boxing match or an MMA match, you're not necessarily gonna, like, hate them, like, yeah, I can't wait till I just pound his face in and just look at the blood. It's more of just like, alright, he's a professional, I'm a professional, we're gonna fight each other here as professionals, okay? With Doffy and Luffy, Doffy really did wanna, like, kill Luffy and lick up his blood afterwards, okay? Doffy wasn't having any of this, like, let's have a respectful, fair match here. No, this was like, okay, you've ruined my entire industry. I had to throw up a birdcage. You've ruined all of my toys. You know, you broke my toys. You know, I am pissed at you right now. You little kids are causing so many problems for me right now. Law and Luffy. Doffy's got the brain vein going on. Like, it's gonna, like, it's just gonna pop at any moment. It's just like, I am gonna enjoy so much shredding the shit out of your bodies with my string and then using them as a puppet while I just use your corpse as, like, to dance for my evening entertainment. And I'm just gonna enjoy that so much. That's what Doffy had when he was fighting against Luffy and Law. You saw that when freaking Doffy used his, like, athlete threaders, like that saw technique, to just slop off Law's arm, and he's on the ground like, oh god, and Doffy's like, you know, so, you know, completely different scenario there, right? So no, Katakuri did not let Luffy win. It's just they had a very different nature to their battle than Doffy did, all right? But that makes Doffy just more ruthless, all right? But I think Katakuri would be able to understand that pretty early on. Katakuri would not try to relate to Doffy in any way. Katakuri would be like, okay, you are obviously an evil, evil guy. You know, you have no remorse for anything. I'm just going to try to eliminate you as quickly as possible. Like, I'm sure Katakuri has been, he's been a Sweet Commander for a long time. He's 48 years old. Katakuri has definitely fought a bunch of really evil, sick pirates throughout his years. All right, people that he just fought and crushed and decimated with absolutely no remorse. Luffy was kind of the exception to that because Luffy was a little bit different. But he would look at Doffy and Katakuri would just be like, okay, I know the kind of guy you are. I know the kind of man you are. In fact, you even have more hatred and evil in you than I'm usually used to seeing. But yeah, I'm not going to try to relate to you or have a fair fight or anything. I'm just going to go full power and just beat the shit out of you. And whoever wins, wins, right? So yeah, observation definitely wins. When it comes to for Katakuri, for armament, I like to think that they're more or less equal there, but just because Katakuri, he mostly relies on that block mochi, he makes the mochi blocks to, like, attack. He does have his spear, Mogura, but his attacks are more like, you know, to use a D&D term, Katakuri's attacks are more like bludgeoning, whereas Doffy's are more like piercing and slashing. So if, you know, he uses haki on his threads to, like, slice through, it would definitely probably slice and cause a little bit more damage than, like, Luffy's attacks on Katakuri, just because I think the slashing, yeah, because we saw that when Luffy went up against Hody, where Luffy's haki was good enough to resist bludgeoning attacks, but when it came to Hody, you know, biting his shoulder with his shark teeth, and it was not enough to stop it. So it seemed like, yeah, Luffy was more, you know, adept at blocking bludgeoning attacks, piercing attacks that, like, stabbing you, that was a different kind of nature. So it might be something similar with Katakuri. Katakuri can make that block mochi really enduring there against brunt attacks, but it's like, you know, I'm hockeying up my thread and slicing it right through you. It might not slice, if Katakuri's hockeying up, Doffy's hockeying up with his thread, yeah, it might not slice all the way straight through Katakuri, but I think it would maybe cut him a little bit. Because Katakuri's mastery was not over armament, it was over observation, okay? He definitely put more stock into his observation, right? So if you want to give haki to Doffy, I think they're more even keel there, but maybe Doffy edges him out in armament a little bit there. Especially when we're getting into, like, the 16 holy bullets, god threads and everything, all these, like, spikes coming at you at once. But, like I said, using his observation, that might not even be a problem for Katakuri. It might not even be an issue with that. It's just like, okay, these ridiculously sharp threads all coated in armament haki are coming right toward me, but I can use my future sight to, like, gulp, 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 and then it just passes right through me, no issue. And then I can just, like, guomp my body and then just reform it and then attack. And then that's it. So yeah, finally we have Conquerors. And Conquerors is, up until this point in the story, has kind of been an ambiguous thing about what it can really do. We know it can knock people out with weak willpower. That's not going to be an issue in this fight, though. You know, Katakuri and Doffy both do not have weak wills, so they're not going to get knocked out by it. And whenever two people that have Conquerors clash, it's like electricity shooting out. It's like energy is just emanating from the attacks. It just kind of gives, like, their punches and their kicks, and whenever they physically meet, just more, like, impact and gravitas. Just like, boom, 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 boom. You know, that's when you fight in a Conqueror battle, okay? Because we don't know much about the inner workings of Conquerors, how, you know, like, during Totland we learned a lot more about observation, right now in Wano we're learning a lot more about armament, because we haven't really learned more about Conquerors yet, just using as the comparison, like, Doffy and Luffy clashed with their Conquerors, they seemed rather equal there. Luffy and Katakuri clashed with their Conquerors, they seemed pretty equal there. I'm gonna say their Conquerors is about on even level there. So, with all that being said here, the person I'm going to give the win to, I kind of already spoiled it because I've said I'm a fan of Katakuri in this fight, so obviously I'm going to go with Katakuri. Barry is, of course, going to go with Doflamingo here. So that's the conclusion I came to. I feel there's just, like, the thing that would really edge Katakuri's victory here is the observation haki and the future sight. All right, Katakuri would not try to, he would not respect Doflamingo. He would not try to have a fair fight. He would try to exterminate him as quickly as possible. The same thing that Doflamingo would be coming out of Katakuri as quickly as possible. Probably with a little bit more of a drive and animosity in Doflamingo's side, definitely. A lot more rage coming from Doflamingo's side than Katakuri's. So he wouldn't have time to think. And maybe that rage and that anger and that just that kind of stuff coming off of him maybe might cloud his judgment. So Doflamingo, I think, think, yeah, he's smart enough to figure out, like, you're using this future sight observation hockey. Maybe I could try to do that myself. Yeah, he's smart enough to do that, but when he gets into a serious fight and the brain veins popping and he's getting really enraged, he might not be able to focus enough to even come up with that, you know, to focus enough to calm down to use that hockey. I'm sure Doflamingo has the potential to unlock that ability. I'm just saying, in the middle of that fight, I don't think he would unlock it, right? And meanwhile, Katakuri is used to, because he's trained in his observation his whole life, Katakuri's way more used to fighting in a clear state of mind, trying to stay calm as much as possible, because if he lets his composure falter, his observation falters. So Katakuri is way more used to, like, staying calm, cool, collected, relying on his observation, seeing the future, bending his body as, and it's like I said, he's been training at this for decades, so it's second nature to Katakuri now to just calm down, see an attack coming, and just reflexively bend his body so the attack passes through. That is second nature to Katakuri. Dofi fights with a lot more rage and anger, and I think that would be his downfall in that particular battle. All right, so at the end of the day, I'm going to give the win here to Katakuri. What do you guys think? Let me know below. I know Doflamingo is probably, definitely more of a beloved villain. Is that a good term to use? Like, can you really love a guy like Doflamingo? I guess you could, conceivably. A much more fan favorite villain. Let's use that instead, you know. He's more popular than Katakuri, I would say, if you're going to rank all of the villains of One Piece. Yeah, I would say Doflamingo would definitely come out ahead there than over Katakuri. But in terms of the battle, like a straight-up fight there, I would say, like, out of 100 battles, Katakuri would definitely win the majority of those, of course. Like, you know, Dofi would win some of them as well. It's not like it would be a curb stomp 100 out of, you know, 100 to 0. But, yeah, Katakuri would definitely win the majority, in my opinion. So let me know what you feel about that below. I always know how this goes. So have a good one, everybody. Tekking, signing out. Later, everybody. You're wrong.